Jimmy Pearsall back here with Lee Corso show, and Lee, the first quarter was a kind of a yawner. It just seemed like nothing got going for either side.
Well, we didn't start off very well, but we played such good defense that we just completely dominated the ball game. In fact, we stymied their run completely until we forced them into a passing game, which was a mistake. We should have let them run the football. Maybe we might have beat them.
Well, let's go to the highlights.
Yeah, it starts off, you know, it's 26,445, the third largest crowd in NIU history. Watch Keller, number 899. He leads the defense and stops the Ball State running game cold as turkey. Look at that. Keller is a fine football player and has played very, very well. But Keller and O'Malley come up next and stop Austin for a four-yard loss. This Austin was a guy that worried us bad, and our defensive coaches did an excellent job of stopping the wham draw, this play right there. Watch O'Malley, Keller, minus four.
I could fake catching the ball better than he fakes handling it off.
I'll tell you what, that kid,
he can pass it, though.
That kid can throw the ball. Here comes Pete Roth around the right end. It's a ground-level shot. You'll see us put a man in motion, toss the ball, and later on, this play is the play of the week. But Pete gets 9 yards in the first play of the game. Good block by Todd Pete, and Pete drives himself down for 9 yards. We tried to go to outside, and they made a great play, but now it's third down and 18. Darrell Taylor gets good pass protection by the line. He throws a shot to Partridge for 22 yards and a first down for Northern.
That looked like a Gilmore pass.
It got right to him, though, Jimmy.
Yeah, I know.
Here comes fourth down and one. We're going for fourth down and one. It's going to be a great play by number 94, Czar, the left inside linebacker. If you watch the left linebacker on the white team who fakes a step up and he blitzes, and they just do make the play right here. He makes us stumble. We do not make it by inches, and they take over. It didn't hurt us, but it sure would have helped us to drive that thing in.
Is their line average about 250 pounds?
At least. Some of them are a little bit bigger than that, but so does the defensive line. Here's third down. That's what we didn't make it by, but we had to go for it. Here's third down and 10. Taylor's back to pass. Great pass protection. He throws a shot right to Akins on a hook pattern. 19 yards and a first down on third and 10. I thought Taylor and Akins is a dynamite player. He always plays well. He makes some big plays. Here's Taylor. Taylor's back to pass. He scrambles around. Watch the great play he makes here. He gets away from the defensive lineman. Starts, throws a shot to Reggie Sims, who's going to be on my show as a special guest. Gets a great block by Akins, number 17, and Reggie Sims goes 42 yards for a touchdown.
Do you think Taylor could have ran more today?
Well, it could have been in some situations, Jimmy, but it's easier to say on Sunday morning what
right.
you could have done.
Okay.
It's just like you and a bases loaded. I told you should have hit that one.
I got to second guess you today.
All right, so can I you. Okay, next. Here's a ground level shot of Sims' touchdown. Watch this. This will give you a good shot. Good pass protection. We fake a screen, and Jimmy Klein's right there. Taylor gets away from 98, throws a pass to Sims. This is exactly the same pass. Good high catch. Watch. Akins gets a good block of number 8, and Sims goes all the way for a touchdown. Reggie will be a guest of mine. He's a senior tight end and did a great job for us. Here's our defense again. Adams is back to pass to Bonanno. Now, you watch in this situation.
Bonanno.
Oh. You've got a few relatives that live in Cicero. I hope not. All right, here comes Keller in again. Now, watch number 99. He will come in from the top of your picture, force the quarterback as a little pitch out. Watch him take the screen play, catch it from behind right here. Boy, is he a terrific player. Forces a fumble. And Lee Hicks, the number 21, is all around the field all day. Terrific player. We do not get it in because of this play coming up right here. It's third and 14. Akins is going into the end zone. We're all fired up there. We got the ball. We got a chance to score. Here it is. Watch this one. We fake the option play. Quarterback comes down the line of scrimmage. He's going to throw. Watch number 14 just deflected at the last minute. Oh, too bad. Too bad. But not very good. We don't get a touchdown right there. This is Taylor and I and Frank Verducci talking over the secret plays we're going to put in. And here's one of them right here. We're coming out of the end zone. We were backed up inside the 5-yard line 4 times. Here is throwing out of the end zone. We got to be crazy. We hit Partridge, 26 yards. If he doesn't stumble, he might have went a few more. But that was crazy, but the only thing
Why
we
is it
do,
crazy? I think it's a good play.
I know, if it worked. If it didn't
sure.
work, it'd be after you. Okay, now here we go with Taylor, back to pass again. He rolls out, makes a good fake to Darrell Richardson. He's rolling out, and he takes off running. Is this what you're talking
That's
about,
That's what
Jimmy?
I'm talking about, yes.
Yeah, he had a couple of opportunities to run, and this was one good one. He goes 17 yards and goes up forward and makes it a great play. Here is a terrific play coming up by number 96, freshman tackle Reggie Harris from Rockford. Watch this play. It's the same way and draw. Reggie gets rid of his ball carrier, knocks him down, and makes a great play. He's going to be a terrific player. He's
we
only a
We don't say boom when we lose, huh?
No, not this week.
Okay.
All right, here's Vern Simmons back to pass. Watch this. Boom.
All boom.
Right, there you have
boom.
It. He drops
Rest.
The ball now. And there's Harris. Recovers the fumble. Not bad for a freshman. The end of the half. We're leading 7-0. And this coach, Ted Dasher, will come up. He works with Reggie Harris.
Well, I'll tell you one thing right now. It looked to me like the first period on tape looked a lot better. Let's see what happens in the second period. We'll be right back right after this message.
Question.
They see that it's going to happen, so let's go to the highlights.
That's right. Let's go to the second half highlights. You'll see us start off with O'Malley on defense here. O'Malley and Slinger do a little twist, which means they change assignments, and O'Malley sacks the quarterback for a 10-yard loss right there. We played very well on defense most of the second half. We got a little tired. That's because we couldn't move the ball. Taylor comes back out, throws a little shot. Boom, 15 yards to Akins. Akins had a terrific night and is an outstanding player. Here is the play of the week. We will put the man in motion to change the coverage. We will toss the ball to Pete Roth. He will come around the end, gets a good block there, gets another block. This is the play of the week. I'll go into and design it for you later on.
Watch the spin here. Yeah. Watch the spin. This is a big spin
Boy,
right here.
Runs Woo. Away from one guy, takes off, and goes 68 yards for a touchdown run. We need this kind of play, but we need more consistency from our offense to take the ball down and drive it down the field. And there's Pete Roth, 68 yards. He had over 121 yards rushing in this ball game, and there's 68 of them right there. At this point of the game, we're ahead 14-0, and we look like we're in control of the game. But they come firing back. Here's Pete Roth off tackle. Gets a good block by Clemens, the right tackle. Runs through a guy right there and goes 23 yards.
Hard to bring him down because he's so low.
Absolutely. He's got great leg power, and he has a low center of gravity, which means he gives it a very difficult subject, and he's a hard guy to hit because he's got such a small bottom line there to hit. Watch this. Boom. Watch Lee Hicks, number 21. This is your favorite, Jimmy. You like this?
Boom.
All right. You like the safety blitz?
Yes.
And there it is for a loss of 10.
Well, I was second-guessing you today.
Absolutely. You should have blitzed more in time. So this is back. Adams back to pass. Gets a nice little quick pass to number George, and he goes for 17 yards.
I like to see a little more bumping at the line, don't you?
Well, you know, sometimes you try to bump him, but the guys avoid you. Here's a situation where it's third down and about 15. He hits a guy right there. Boom. 19 yards. Almost got a first down. He sets up a field goal. But this is enough to make you cry right here. This field goal. Watch this guy.
I didn't think it was a field goal, but you know, watch how it proves it is right here.
46 yards. It hits the crossbar and goes in. Now you say, what's that got to do with it? That's 3 points. The score is now 14-3. We're still up by 11. But I'll tell you what, if you'd have missed that one, well, here we go. Adams is back to pass. He's going to throw a little wide out pass. The guy jumps up in the air. Smith does and makes the catch. 14-9 now.
Boy, thrown across his body. Tough pass for a left-hander.
Left-hander, but he did a good job of it. You got to give him credit on there. Here's Ball State tries for two. We got good coverage here by Hicks and Vaughn. He throws it out to Austin. They break it down. Hicks makes a good tackle, and we stop him there. We're still leading 14-9. Here's Ricky Mitchell. They kick off. Watch this play. Mitchell gets it about the end zone line. He's going to start up the left side. Gets a good block by three or four men, and particularly Richardson, number 35, will get a good block up here, and he goes 55 yards.
Watch who stops him, the kicker.
Here's Richardson's good block.
Look at that.
Number two, ducks, falls over the guy. Now, here comes Lee Hicks. We thought we had the ball in there. We couldn't get it in, but Lee Hicks saves a touchdown coming up right here. Lee Hicks is playing like an all-MAC player without a question in my mind. He goes, the pass is deflected in the air. Hicks picks it off. Now, we almost go all the way. Watch number 40, who misses him the first time, comes back and gets in the second time. And Lee Hicks avoids one player and gets tripped up by number 40. All right, we're going all the way. And I'm going to tell you, Jim, I hate to show this play because it's, I hate to show the play, but I got to show it because this is the ball game.
Boy, I want to tell you, you got your ear sets off right there.
Well, I tell you what, I'm listening to the defensive call. It's got to be a good call. It's three deep coverage. The guy throws it in the corner. Watch this one. Oh, I don't want to see it.
Oh, no, let's get right away from it. You know, we're going to come back for the play of the week, Coach. We won't show that one, okay? And we'll be right back with the score, with the blackboard right after this.
Play right there. Take a look at it. You'll love it. Now, watch it. You'll see the man pull. Now, watch the right guard, number 76, pull. And now there's the block by, you saw the block by Kincaid. Now, there's number 80, misses. 47 overruns him. And Pete Roth goes 68 yards for a touchdown. And at that time, we were in control of the ball game. We could not hold on. We lost 15-14 in a tough, tough game.
After the game, the coach talks to two of his disappointed players, and really, it's in the locker room, so kind of tough for the coach, kind of tough for the players, but they get it done.